questions I had given yesterday as homework that we will solve, and later on we will go for understanding the uniform and non-uniform motion, their graph, and with the help of graph we will learn about the other kinetic equation, other two kinetic equation, exclusively the s equals to ut plus half a t square. So this was the question that I had given you yesterday as a homework. I think you people might have solved it, but you people have some doubt. So the question number 1, in question number 1, when will you say that the body is uniformly accelerated and non uniformly accelerated? A student, last day we have started with
equal distances and equal interval of time.
Students, last day we have discussed with the term like uniform. Uniform means something equal. Okay, this equal is taken with reference to, means with respect to certain interval of time. Okay, say if the distance covered is equal, means equal distance in equal interval of time, it is called as uniform motion. A student, this motion means this is your uniform speed. It simply means that. So uniform means something fixed or something equal. But if it is asked for uniform acceleration, then the same concept you have to apply, but with reference to acceleration, not this speed. So if acceleration is constant, then it is uniform. What was happening for uniform motion or uniform speed? Here the speed was constant. Here the speed was constant. Though velocity might be changing, but the speed was constant. So because of the speed is constant, the body is covering equal distance in equal interval of time, it is called as uniform motion or uniform speed. But if we come in term of acceleration, then this uniform acceleration, this simply means the body is moving with a constant acceleration. Body have fixed acceleration value. So if the body have or moving with a constant acceleration, so what do we mean by this constant acceleration? Acceleration that we are knowing that it is change in velocity or change in speed. So constant acceleration simply mean the speed is increasing continuously at the same rate in given interval of time. So here, so body or like the uniform motion, where we were considering the distance, here we may consider the speed. So if the body speed is increasing or decreasing at a fixed rate in given interval of time, then its acceleration is said to be uniform. So the concept is the same, but the term is only changed. So this you have to understand. So write down the definition. If a body speed is changing, a student, that we have learned that this changing may be your increase तो इंक्रीजेस और डिक्रीजेस इधर ऑफ दिस बाय फिक्स्ड अमाउंट और बाय इक्वल अमाउंट इन इक्वल इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम. Then it is called as uniform acceleration. Means A must have some value. A is not changing. Acceleration is not changing. A student, in last few questions we have seen that during the motion of a body, acceleration may also change. But we need not change the acceleration. Then only we can say body is uniformly accelerated or uniform acceleration. A is fixed. If A is varying, means acceleration is varying, then it becomes non-uniform acceleration. Non-uniform acceleration means acceleration is changing. Now this change in acceleration may be due to direction or may be due to your magnitude. Means the body is not covering equal or body is not having equal increase or decrease in speed in equal interval of time. So here it is important that we have to express in the term of speed. So body speed is not changing equally in equal interval of time. So a student, the time interval is always equal. If the speed change is equal, then it will be uniform. If the speed change is not equal, then it is non-uniform. So it is what you have to keep in mind. The concept of the term like uniform and non-uniform remains the same. So here we have discussed about uniform versus non-uniform acceleration. So acceleration means we have to look for the term acceleration or the change in speed. For uniform speed, we have to look for the term the distance covered. So that way we have to think. A student, I had also told you that there are three kinetic equations. So keep in mind that three kinetic equation is applicable for uniform acceleration only. So right on the uniform side, so three kinetic equation are applicable here to find the unknown or to analyze the motion. Means what is the distance covered, what is the displacement, what will be the time taken. What this kinetic equation that you are already knowing, the very first is the definition of acceleration, the arranging it that we can get. V is equals to U plus AT. The next one is the displacement S is equals to ut plus half at square. Next one is this velocity square is equals to u square plus 2as. These are the three kinetic equation. And in this case, sign is very important of vector is important because we have learned that vector quantity have sign, means they could be positive or they could be negative or they could be zero. So accordingly we have to take, means A may be your positive if the speed is increasing, or A may be your negative. Similarly, even this V is your velocity, may be your positive or may be your negative. Even the S represented here is the displacement, may be positive or negative. In this case, S is our displacement, not the distance. This V, it is our velocity. This is our acceleration. So students, you have to keep in mind, under this condition only, these three kinetic equation is applicable to calculate the other unknown quantity. Even just by substituting, we can also get average velocity in this case is given by initial velocity plus final velocity by 2. This is also the same. I mean, this is your average velocity. So average velocity may be calculated by adding the initial and final velocity, dividing it by 2. So this is also applicable for uniformly accelerated motion. Means A must have some value, means A must be some real value. So acceleration can be any real number, maybe your 2, 5, minus 2, etc, something like that, that we have seen, it could be positive or negative. So this is about your accelerated motion. Right hand side we have written for uniform accelerated motion, or uniformly accelerated motion, or simply accelerated motion. In non-uniform accelerated motion, these three kinetic equations are not applicable. Here, A is not constant. Means A itself, it will change. Means what? If I am considering this two part of a journey, so starting from A to B, B to C, here the acceleration, say 2 m/s². In next part of journey, if the acceleration is 4 m/s² and you are considering the same interval of time, means TAB you are taking 3 seconds, also time for B to C you are also taking as 3 seconds, then you are observing that acceleration value is different. We were observing last day that, see, in this uniform motion, means uniform speed, this motion means it is the uniform speed simply. So whether it is a stated uniform motion or uniform speed means the same. Here we were observing that the speed in each of the interval was same, but for non-uniform, the speed was varying. Okay, so the same concept is applied in the term of acceleration, then it is uniform. If not, then it is non-uniform. Okay, students. So therefore, this A is not constant, so A is changing. But in this case, the value of acceleration is always the same. So if I take Okay, students, so to draw this, let me create few space. Means in this case, if you are considering A to B, B to C, whatever the time, say 2 second, in that the acceleration will be fixed one. Say acceleration is equals to 5 meter per second square. Here also acceleration will be 5 meter per second square. And we have learned acceleration is due to increase in speed or the change in direction of velocity. Means the speed is continuously increasing. So in this case, speed increase we have considered. Increase or decrease, the body change equally, the speed of the body changes equally, but in non-uniform the speed of the body is not changing equally. So different amount of speed increase in same interval. Ready? How you can understand that? If I am considering from A to B, let me take the speed at A as 0 meter per second, means the body started from the rest, then the body finally attending say 6 meter per second speed, then acceleration will be 6 minus 0 by 3, it becomes 2. Okay, here in this interval the acceleration is 6 meter per second minus 0 meter by the interval 3 we have taken. So that's why I have written this as 2 meter per second. In this case, this have reached to 18 meter per second. Now in this case, means from here to here, what is the acceleration? The acceleration is calculated by 18 minus 6 divided by the time taken is 3. It was 12 by 3, it was 4 meter per second. Now what we are observing, this is 4 in this interval and this is 2. So acceleration is different in different interval of time, therefore it is non-uniform. But in this case, the speed increase will be such that the acceleration will be same. So if you are considering here 0 was the initial and it is able to reach 10 meter per second, then here it is again able to reach to 20 meter per second. A student, in this case what we are observing, in this interval the speed increase is 10 meter per second. In this interval also the speed increase is 10 meter per second. Means increase in speed is same. So acceleration is the same. You may calculate the acceleration here, 20 minus 10 by the time interval is 2. So it is 5 meter per second. Here also the acceleration is 10 minus 0 by 2. You will get the 5 meter per second. So this way you can anticipate or you can determine whether the increase in speed is fixed or not. So on right hand side, for uniform speed, we are observing that the speed is always increasing by 10 meter per second. But in left hand side or non-uniform motion, we are observing that in this interval, the speed have increased by 6 meter per second. But in this interval, the speed have increased by 18 minus 6, 12 meter per second. So when this speed change is not fixed, then it is non-uniform. But in this case, we have written the speed change is our 10 meter per second. So it was 5 meter per second square was the acceleration, but change was 20 minus 10.
Sir, 20 minus 10 by 2 is equal to 2.
Yes, tell me.
5 meter per second.
5 meter per second square is the acceleration, student. But what is the speed change? Speed change is 10 meter per second only. Understand this? This I want to explain. Initially, the speed was 0, it have reached to 10 meter per second. What is changing is speed only, not the acceleration. 10 minus 0, it is 10 meter per second. Then in next 2 seconds, the speed have increased from 10 to 20 meter per second. Means what is the speed increase? It is again 10 meter per second. So that's why the speed increase is same. This is the meaning of increase in speed. But in this case, we are observing, means in non-uniform, initial speed increase was 6 meter per second, but later on the speed increase was 12 meter per second. So if the change in speed is different, then surely it will be non-uniform acceleration or non-uniformly accelerated motion. So it is also written as non-uniformly accelerated motion. A student, you have to keep in mind, if the term motion only given, means it is related to speed. Okay, accelerated motion if this is given, it is related to your acceleration. So this is how you shall make the difference and you shall understand what the question mean basically. So whatever the three equation, x equals to ut plus half at square, v equals to u plus at, those things are not applicable for non-uniform accelerated motion. We will see in the graph that in this case, that graph we will learn today. If I draw the graph, then this is the time versus this is the speed or velocity, then accelerated motion, it is this one. It is velocity versus time graph. So this will give us the acceleration. This we will see today. But in this case, we will see the graph is something like this. It will not be constant, but it will be increasing. This is your velocity, this is your time. Okay, student, so this is the graph. So from the graph, we can also observe the speed is increasing. That thing we will learn today. Any more doubt to any student, then please ask. So student, do not just mug up
questions last part.
Okay, do not mug up the question directly or the definition directly from any book. You please understand. Once you get understand what is that mean, you can quickly anticipate what are the possibilities, which equation can be applied or which equation we cannot apply. So all these things are very much important. What will be the graph? Those things you can also understand easily. So a student, I think second question is over. So bus decreases its speed from 80 meter, a bus decreases its speed from 80 kilometer per hour to 60 kilometer per hour in 5 seconds, find the acceleration. Question 2 is very easy. A student, in question number 2, what is important? Time, 5 seconds. Speed is like this one. It is in kilometer per hour. So first you will convert this in the term of meter per second. Then only you can do it.
Sir, I got minus 4000 meter per second square.
Yes, it is possible. Okay, student, let me explain a bit for the second question. So question number two. So for second question, you must understand, you first note down what is given in this question. So bus, means you just understand, you just draw the bus by a round ball or something like that. So you have to write the decreases its speed, means speed is going to decrease from 80 kilometer per hour to 60 kilometer per hour. Means initially the body or this bus is moving with this speed of 80 kilometer per hour. Then after some time the speed have decreased. So that speed is denoted by V, and this speed is your 60 kilometer per hour, and time taken to decrease in speed is given as T is equals to 5 seconds. Student, unit is important here because time is given in second and this speed are given in kilometer per hour. So first we need to convert it into meter per second. For converting meter per second, 80 have to be multiplied with the 1000 and hour 60 into 60, or you may directly multiply with the 5 by 18. That way you can also get. Why that? Because on cancelling this you will get the same thing. It is 3, it is 5, so 5 by 18, 6 threes are 18. So you may further cancel the 2 from here, it become 40, so it become 200 by 9 meter per second. Here you may also convert this into meter per second, so multiply it by 1000, divide it by 60 into 60, so this become 60 into 5 by 18, it is like this one on cancelling this side. So 3 times, so it becomes 50, means the 10 time it become by 3 meter per second. A student, you are free to choose this unit, meter per second. Even if you wish, you can convert the time itself into hour, then you can calculate it. Therefore, acceleration, what is the formula for acceleration? V minus u by t. Don't mind for whether it is negative or positive, that we have learned. It could be negative. Negative tells it is deceleration or decrease in speed. So it will be our final is 50 by 3 minus 200 by 9 whole divided by this 5. Student, this fraction you have to solve properly, and we have also solved in this such expression in chapter 1 of our mathematics, that this is in numerator, so you have to take the difference, so LCM become 9, then this is this 3 will go 3 times to make it 9, therefore the 50 will multiply with this 3, and this 209 is going only one time, so will remain the same. This is to be divided by 5, so by taking the reciprocal we can write this as 1 by 5. Okay, it is like a by b whole by c, then it become a by b into 1 by c, so we can directly write it here. Taking the difference, it become 150 minus 200, it become minus 50 divided by 9, into 1 by 5. Here the unit is important. It is meter per second square. Okay, student? You may cancel this. So it becomes minus of 10 by 9 meter per second square. This is the final answer. So negative indicate it is retardation. Okay, student? Other thing, if you want, you may express the result in form of decimal also. So going for decimal, how many times? It becomes 1 point. Still one is left. 1, 1 means 1.1 recurring. So it is 1.1 meter per second square. Here negative sign indicates what? Deceleration. But the answer you have to write along with this sign. Don't worry for that. Means the body is moving in this direction. Initially, this was the speed u. This is v. So velocity is in this direction. This is the direction of velocity. Velocity is in forward direction. But what is direction of acceleration? So this velocity is in positive direction. So this is positive direction. Here we are observing that acceleration is negative. So acceleration is in opposite direction to that of the velocity. So this is the direction of acceleration. That is, acceleration is opposite to direction of motion. So student, this is another important observation. Is it necessary that acceleration should be in the direction of motion? No, not at all. Acceleration may be opposite to the direction of motion. Here motion was, means the motion of the body is moving rightward. But what is acceleration? Acceleration is leftward. So wherever the speed is decreasing, the acceleration will be opposite to the direction of motion. That you have to keep in mind. Other example that you will also come across in vertical motion. Say if you throw a ball, this is important point. If you throw a ball upward or downward, then the body have inherent acceleration called acceleration due to gravity. If it is allowed to fall downward toward the earth, then is speed continuously increasing and acceleration is positive. Means acceleration is in vertically downward direction. Speed is increasing, but speed or velocity is also downward. But if you throw a ball upward, then you will observe that the speed is decreasing. Though the body is moving upward, its speed will decrease. Then after a certain time, it will reach at the top of its journey where it will momentarily come at rest. Then it will fall again downward. So the body is able to come to rest only after decrease in its speed. So at that time, the acceleration will again go downward. So acceleration will again go downward, but speed is your upward. So this way, in vertical motion also, if the body is moving vertically downward, acceleration is positive, velocity is positive. If the body is moving upward, then acceleration is taken downward as positive, then speed is negative. Or if the upward direction is taken, speed is positive, then acceleration is negative. Means sine of the velocity and acceleration will surely be opposite to each other. Okay, so this we will also see in more detail while we will solve the kinetic equation. A student, so this is important thing that you have to understand, that velocity and acceleration need not be in same direction. So here in MCQ it may be asked that while the body is moving with decreasing speed, acceleration will be in direction of speed, or will in the direction of motion, or opposite to the direction of motion. So while the speed is decreasing, acceleration is opposite to the direction of motion. While the speed is increasing, acceleration is in the direction of motion. So this is applicable for a straight line motion. So write that point also. If speed is increasing, and this we are considering over a straight line, means motion over the straight line we are considering, then acceleration is positive, and this acceleration is in the direction of motion. Just opposite to this, if speed is decreasing, again the motion we are considering over the straight line, then acceleration is negative, and is in direction opposite to the motion of body. So this is what important. So do not think that if the body is moving in this direction, acceleration will always be in rightward or in this direction. Acceleration may be in this direction if speed is increasing. This may be in this direction, means opposite. This is the direction indicating the direction of motion. If V is decreasing. So student, concept of acceleration is very important, because by knowing this acceleration we can anticipate what will be the direction of applied force. And since force, this we will learn in second chapter, but still we can correlate here, is given by mass into acceleration. This you might have learned in class 8th or 7th. So therefore this force is always in direction of acceleration. Force F is what? This is force, is in direction of acceleration. So student, you can understand simply that if the body is moving, we want to stop it, means it is the u, but finally v is going to be zero. How it can stop? By applying the brake. So what this brake is doing? It is applying a force opposite to the direction of motion of body. It is basically applying a negative acceleration. So a force in this direction is applied by the brake. So this is what force is applied in negative direction. So force is applied opposite to the direction of motion to stop it. So this is what the important thing. So this is nothing but this is the case of deceleration. So these are the things that you have to keep in mind. So you may analyze in the term of force, in which direction the force is applied, and the direction of acceleration also. What will be the direction of acceleration? That you can also tell. Okay, student. So this was all about our analysis of this chapter. Any doubt, then please ask. Otherwise, I will go. You have doubt in last portion? Student, here I am explaining that this, even we will learn more detail in our next chapter called Newton's Laws of Motion, where we will learn that force is given by mass into acceleration. So see, acceleration could be in direction of motion or could be in opposite to the direction of motion. If acceleration is in direction of motion, it means speed is increasing. If acceleration in direction opposite to the acceleration, it means speed is decreasing. Now, if speed is decreasing, acceleration is negative. Means the body will stop after some time. So how a moving body can be stopped? By applying a force opposite to the direction of motion. Means it is force is in direction of acceleration. Basically, direction of deceleration here. That I had explained here. If the body have to stop, then acceleration is opposite to the direction of motion. So this is our direction of motion. Motion is in this direction, but acceleration and force are in this direction. It is this way. This is the acceleration and force direction. Above one means rightward is the motion direction. Okay, student, this I was explaining. Any more doubt? Because if you want to have a good knowledge of physics, so these are the very basic thing where you need to understand what these terms are. Not only understand, but how it is practically appear in our daily life. Because physics is nothing but a study about the nature and natural phenomena, what we are observing in our daily life. So why the car is able to stop? So able to stop because of the braking. Braking gives a negative acceleration. Means applies a force opposite to the direction of motion of the car. So motion is in forward direction, but the applied force or acceleration is in the backward direction. Okay? So if I consider this as the forward direction, then these two things, these are our backward direction. So while applying the brake, the applied force and acceleration is in the backward direction. That we have to keep in mind. Okay? Student, any more doubt, then please ask. Otherwise, I shall go for the next question and next topic.
No doubt, sir.
This is very important, student. This is very important. Chapter 1, I always teach very slowly because it contains a lot of concept. And that concept is applied in every next chapter. So, main aapko first chapter har cheez ko bahut slow isliye padhata hu. Aap dekhenge, laws of motion mein hum quickly ye sab cheeze, force ka direction, ye sab hum calculate karenge and we are able to quickly write the answer. Once if you are understanding this, What is the direction of acceleration? You can anticipate the direction of force very easily. Okay. How to calculate acceleration? That we have also learned. There we will also see that if the body is moving on a circular path with constant speed, means there is no change in speed, but still a force have to be applied. Why? To give the change in this direction. Change in direction means acceleration. Acceleration means there is some force is needed. So this thing detail we will learn in our next chapter. Yes, students. So this was all about our the second question. So what is the numerical value in second question that I have written, and what is the importance of this? That even I have also explained. Now let us come to the third question. Third question again, a student have doubt?
Students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. A student, let me do this third question also. Because these questions are very important. So that's why we cannot just skip this and tell the definition of each term and end the chapter. So स्टूडेंट जस्ट उस तरीके से करेंगे तो बहुत अच्छा आप नहीं सीख पाएंगे एंड इट बिकम लाइक अवर स्कूल. सो दिस इज नॉट द स्कूल, दिस इज टू नर्चर यू पीपल, मेक यू पीपल लर्न मोर एंड मोर टू डेवलप योर कॉन्सेप्ट. इट इज फॉर दैट वन. सो इसके लिए थोड़ा आपको ओपन माइंडेड रहना है, थोड़ा पेशेंटली पढ़ना है. इफ यू आर डूइंग जस्ट बिलीव मी, जस्ट इन 2 to 3 months यू विल ऑब्जर्व द changes in yourself. आपको फिर आप खुद ही कोई क्वेश्चन दे करके आपको लगेगा कि you are able to solve it. Even you become eager to solve such a question because you know the concept. So student, let me explain the question number 3 also. For this third part, student, write the given information in numerical or in symbol form. So a train starting from a railway station. So just read the question part wise, note down the given information. So when a body is starting means what? It was initially at rest. When initially at rest means its initial speed is zero. So it is something like this. So u value is zero. That you have to keep in mind. So starting from rest means u is equals to zero. This we have enumerated at one of the position. That you can also see. A student, I have listed everything here. See, what do we mean by acceleration? What is the speed when the body starts from rest? So body starts from rest, initial speed is zero. If the body come to rest, final speed is zero. So these terms, I mean start from rest, it simply means you are given with the initial speed. Coming to rest means you are given with the final speed. Get it? So this is what the significance of this term. So this thing you have to apply properly, then only you are able to solve the numericals. So student, here a train starting from a railway station means u is equals to zero and moving with uniform acceleration. See, the term uniform acceleration is used, means whatever the fixed value of acceleration we are taking, that is the our uniform acceleration. We are discussing all these things for the uniform acceleration only. So acceleration is given. So write the acceleration here. The acceleration is, the value of acceleration given is, no, the value of acceleration is not given, but it is simply given as it is a constant acceleration or uniform acceleration that we want to calculate. Moving with uniform acceleration, attains a speed of this much in 10 minutes. So finally, it have attained the speed of 40 kph. The final speed is given as v is equals to 40 km/h. It is given. The time to change this speed from here to here, it is given that 10 minutes. Again, a student, question is very simple. In this case, you have to bring all this in the same system of unit while applying the formula. I had already told you, put the better habit that you apply the SI unit for all the given quantity. So zero remains the zero. So U is equals to U, whether you write 0 kph or 0 m/s, that doesn't make any sense. Okay, because 0 × 1000/60 remains zero. So that's why for the zero value, unit is not much significant. You have to just take the unit, whatever you need. But what about this V? So V is given as 40 km/h. A student, I have told you, you convert this into m/s.
40 × 1000/60 × 60,
this much m/s. Or many a time we are just multiplying this by 5/18 m/s. That also gives the same result, because these two are getting cancelled here, and this become 5 and this become 3 only. So 3 × 6 = 18 in denominator and 5 in numerator. So you just cancel whatever the common things are there. So it become 9, it become 20. So it become 100/9 m/s. So here we are taking in SI unit. So do the same thing for the time. Time given is your 10 minute. So better to convert it into second into 60, so it is 600 seconds. Now you have to write, since acceleration formula is v minus u by t. Now you substitute. Therefore, this value of acceleration a v is, we have calculated here in m/s, so that value we have to put 100/9 minus, initially it was 0, divided by the time is our 600. So minus 0 doesn't make any sense. So it is 100/9 × 1/600. A student, you must know to simplify the fraction. Yadi aap nahi janenge to galtiyan ho jayenge. So these two 0 will get cancelled.
1/54
m/s². This could be the answer. Answer may be given in km/h, not. So right, in other unit, you may calculate in other unit also. So what is given? U is given as 0. V is given as our 40 km/h. T is given as 10 minutes. So we may convert this minute itself in the hour. So it is 10/60, this much hour. So 1/6 of hour. Now here we have not converted the V. Then acceleration, applying the formula, it is V minus U by T. And here we will put the velocity in the unit of km/h. So it is 40 km/h minus 0 means 0 km/h, divided by the time is 1/6 of hour. A student, keep in mind, it is 1 by 6 means it will go for multiplying. So it is 40 by 1 into 6. See, 40 by 1 is there, then it is 6. So it will go in numerator. So it become, the unit is important here, kilometer per hour square. So just multiply this, 240 kilometer per hour square. Student, so whether you take this value or this value, both are same. But here it is the unit that is making the difference. Okay, you can check it also. If I want to convert this, whether these two are same or not. So if I'm going for converting this, how I can convert this into meter per second square? So let me write, converting into meter per second square. For that, what we have, the acceleration value is our 240 kilometer per hour square. A student, here you have to understand, it is 240 into 1 kilometer. In denominator, it is 1 hour square. This thing you have to keep in mind. So it become like this. 240 is the number that we have to keep as it is. 1 kilometer need to be converted into meter so that we can get the result in meter per second square. So substitute 1000 of meter. But in denominator, it is 1 hour. So 1 hour need to be converted into seconds. So put the bracket as it is, because bracket is a squared. Means it is 60 into 60, that much second, this much square. Means this square, or this square term, is for both of these 60. So how many times I have to write this 60? 4 times. So 2400, or if you wish, you may take the other 30 here, or you may write in the multiplication itself. So in denominator, it become 60 into 60 into 60 into 60. A student are making confusion in this step only. They are just thinking that it is a square means only 160 into 60. No. The square term is for both of the 60 which are inside this bracket, because we have converted 1 hour in the term of second. So the unit become meter per second a square. Now you cancel the possible 0, 1 0, 2 0, 3 0, 4 0. So these 4 0 are cancelled. 6 4 0. Okay. Now this 2 0 and this is 3 0. This 2 0. This is again 3 0. So it is simply in numerator it is 1. Denominator it is 3 into 3 into 6. What is this? The unit is important. Yes. So it is in meter per second square. This is 1 by 54 meter per second square. So students, whether you calculate in kilometer per hour or meter per second square, the value is the same. It is because of the different unit, the numerical value appears to be as different. Okay. So in MCQs or in your examination, the unit may be anyone. So you must know how to convert these units from one system of unit to other system of unit. Okay, dear students, any doubt then please ask, otherwise I have solved. In your answer, I mean in your textbook, the answer may be given in the kilometer per hour, then this is the answer. If it is given in meter per second, then 1 by 54 is the answer. Any doubt then please ask. Otherwise, I had explained everything.
No, sir.
No doubt.
Okay. So now let me go for the topic what I was discussing, called uniform and non-uniform motion, that we have discussed. In addition to that, we have also seen today, there could be uniform acceleration or non-uniform acceleration. So uniform motion means it is related to speed and uniform acceleration means it is related to acceleration. To understand the uniform motion or uniform speed, we have to consider the equal distance and equal interval of time. To understand uniform acceleration or fixed acceleration, we have to consider equal increase in speed in equal interval of time. So that thing you have to keep in mind. So these two are the very important concept. Now let me go for plotting the graph of this uniform motion. From that graph, we will derive the kinetic equation. That is, S equals to ut plus half at square, that we will derive. Okay? So student, let us go for the plot or graph of uniform and non-uniform motion. So we are going to put the graph. A student, last day I had just given you a brief introduction that these graphs are plotted among which variables and why they are. That thing I have given you. So here I have discussed, the student, if you could recall this part, then please recall this thing. Let me copy this so that I need not write it again.
Hello.
Yes, I am here. Any doubt?
No, sir.
So I was just copy. Now let me post it here. So pasting it here. A student, recall the last topic that we have started. Graph of different type of motion. What are the different type of motion that I have explained here? That it could be your uniform or non-uniform. These are the different type of motion. So therefore, whether I write the graph for uniform or non-uniform motion or graph for different type of motion, that we have to analyze. And we have learned that motion includes your change in distance or displacement, change in velocity or the speed, or there is an associated speed, there is associated acceleration. Therefore, all these things, distance or displacement, speed or velocity, acceleration, these things have to be observed with reference to time. Therefore, for plotting it, time is taken along the x-axis or along the horizontal axis. And the other quantity, like maybe your distance or velocity or acceleration, these have to be plotted in vertical direction or on the vertical axis. So this is our vertical axis. A student, any point in this, say if I am taking a point here, this is the graph for time versus distance covered. If I am taking a point P here, this P, from P you have to draw a perpendicular line over the T axis and another perpendicular line over the SS axis. So this is our distance axis, this is our time axis. Then whatever this value of time is starting from this origin, and whatever this value of time that you are observing, some numerical value will be given over this axis that we will see. So it may be possible that from here to here it is our 1 second. Let me write this time in second. Here it is your 2 second. After that there is 3 second, there is 4 second, and you are also observing that here up to this much I am plotting this as 5 meter, this as 10 meter, this as 15 meter. Let me plot uniformly. It appear non-uniform. So let me write this as 5 meter, this as 10 meter, this as 15 meter, next one is our 20 meter, next one will be 25 meter. So students, in this fashion, the plot always have one of the variable time along the x-axis and another variable like distance, or in place of distance, there may be your velocity also. There may be acceleration also. So these two could be in place of this distance. So you have to observe carefully. From the unit, you can get it what is the plot for this vertical axis, or on vertical axis, what is plotted or what is put. So here we are getting that the unit is meter, means on vertical axis, the distance is considered. And on horizontal axis, the time is considered. So after observing this, means from this plot, we can observe that if the body is at P, it means at T is equals to 2 second, because body in this S versus T plane, this is the S versus T plane. So this rightward is our S versus T plane. So in this plane, any point is representing two quantity. One is the time, another is the distance covered. So if the body is at P, it means it is at 2 second, the body have, or body have a distance of 15 meter. It is this one. Similarly, can Chandan tell me if I am taking this one, say as the Q, this point is our Q. Means this Q, from this Q, if you are plotting a perpendicular on this T axis, it is touching at 1 second, and while putting a perpendicular on this distance axis, it is falling at 20 meter. So what this Q signifies, at what time this Q is, and what is this
1 second and 20 meter?
Yes, tell me.
1 second and 20 meter.
Good. So this indicate at 1 second the body is 20 meter away from the origin. Means what? If you are starting the journey from here, where you are considering the starting point as A, then initially means at 1 second the body was, means this is the time T1. So at this 1 second, the body was at this point Q, which is 20 meter. But after 1 more second, means at T is equals to 2 second, the body have reached to this P, This P is your 10 meter. It is this 10. This is your 20. Okay? Means this signifies that the body is moving toward the origin or toward the observer. This A is the observer. So this way you have to watch the plot carefully, or if the data are given, then you have to put it in the ST plane. Okay, student? So student, you also have to write this again. आपने इसको इसको लिखने हैं फिर से. Means यहां से motion, ये जो चीजें हमने लिखे हैं, S not equals to zero or S can be zero. V may or may not be zero. A may or may not be zero. So all this variation always occur with time. Therefore, this time is always plotted along the horizontal axis as one of the independent variable. And the other quantities like distance, velocity, and acceleration, which is depending on this time, therefore it is plotted along vertical axis. In one graph or at a time, only one of the variable or one of the quantity is plotted. Either S may be plotted, or V may be plotted, or A may be plotted. In higher standard, you will learn in the same plot, we may plot these three also. So that we will learn later. Or you will learn in higher standard. So student, to explain that, I have taken a time interval over the horizontal axis and I have plotted this graph here. So in this graph, along the time axis, I have taken the scale of 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, 4 second, like this one. It is going on, it is increasing. And on the vertical axis, I have taken the distance covered. And distance covered, I have plotted at the interval of 5 meter. So from 0 to 5, it is 5 meter. 0 to 10, it is 10 meter. A student, you have to keep in mind, this is 0 to 5, okay? From here to here, it is 0 to 10. It is 10. If anyone is asking between 10 to 5, what is this gap? If anyone is asking only this much, then this is given by 10 minus 5. This is 5 meters. So this is what the increase. This tells us the increase or decrease. Increase with reference to 5 and decrease with reference to 10. If anyone is asking from 15 meter to 25 meter, means the body is initially at 15 meter and later on it have moved to 25 meter. What is the gap between this, or what is the distance between this 25 meter and 15 meter? Then you have to subtract this 25 minus 15. It is your 10. So this way you have to understand carefully that in this plot, we can calculate the absolute position or absolute value of distance and displacement, as well as we can calculate the change. Okay, so change is always between two given segment or two given plotted points. So change may be in term of this time or maybe in the term of displacement or distance. Say, if anyone is asking to you 2 to 3 seconds, the body is observed from 2 to 3 seconds. What is the time interval here? The delta T is 1 second one. Okay. If anyone is asking from 1 to 2 seconds, what is the observation time? It is our 1 second. Likewise, here we have plotted the body initially at P, means which is at the 2 second, and later on it have moved to Q, which is at 1 second. Okay. So this way, these variations we can consider. So how is the motion? So motion is along P to Q. So this way, these variations can be plotted. So these variations we have to plot or we have to observe. Then we have to tell how is the graph of uniform motion or the graph of non-uniform motion. A student, just bear with me for another 15 minutes. I will able to plot a graph, then we will stop the class. Okay, a student? So students, I told you I have written all these things. V versus t, we can plot all these things. We can plot. Student, for plotting, let me take one example. The position, or let us draw, or let us write a numerical itself, so that we can understand this. The position of a moving body is tabulated . So in this table you are given with the position, means the location, and another at what time this position is. So that time is given, means this is like x you are given, this is like t you are given. Students, let us take at t is equals to 0, the body was at 0 position. 0, 0 means it is starting from, this is our t, this is our x. Then at this point, the t is 0 and x both are 0. This is called as origin. In mathematics, we will learn, or even in class 8, it was there. Another, after 2 seconds, so this is given in the unit second, this is given in the unit meter. After 2 seconds, the body was observed at 6 meter distance, and at 4 seconds, the body was observed at, so let me take this as 8 meter. Or let me take this as the 12 itself. At 6 seconds or 1 second, don't worry that I am taking the interval of 2. One may take the 5th second, 6 second, or every second. Let me take this as 15. At the 6th second, let me take this as 18. At the 10th second, let me take this as the 30. Or if it is very big, then we can stop it here. Okay, let me take at the 12th second, at 36. So these are the given.
36.
Then plot it in xt. X, or maybe position given in the term of S itself. Okay, xt or st graph. इसमें आपको ये plot करना है. Also tell whether the motion, whether the body is in rest or motion, that is one thing that you have to tell. Whether the body is in rest or motion. The next thing, if the body is in motion, then you have to tell, also give the type of motion. A student, type of motion means you have to tell whether it is uniform or non-uniform. These things. From this graph we will see, if it is in motion, means then we can calculate its speed or velocity. So also calculate speed or write in bracket velocity if it can be. We will also see if there is a speed or velocity, then we can calculate the acceleration. So what about the acceleration? Means whether it is uniformly accelerated, non-uniformly accelerated, or no acceleration is there, that we have to see. Okay, students, so let us do this. We will do it. So first we have to plot this table. So for plotting this, you have to take the time along the horizontal axis and this position or displacement along the vertical axis. Then in that ST plane, you have to plot it. So let me just take it. Students, for plotting, you must understand some thing or very few basic thing of your geometry. The basic thing of geometry is that if, so in geometry or in your geometrical figure, what you have learned till this standard, let me just illustrate that. You might have learned something can be plotted along this x-axis and something can be plotted along this vertical y-axis. If a point P is here, it must have a x-coordinate and this has y-coordinate. So x coordinate means this value of x. If this is x1, then this value is x1. This has y1, then what is this value? Means here to here, it is our y1. The same thing we will apply here also, but what makes difference? We are not plotting the other three quadrant. We are interested in this first quadrant itself. So these three quadrant means other negative quadrant are not required. So here we will do the same thing where T is plotted along the horizontal axis and this X or denoted as S is plotted along the vertical axis. Okay, so if we have a body at, so at 2 seconds, the body at 5 meters. So I have to go for 2 seconds here. The unit will be given like 1, 2, 3, so on. Then I have to move for the vertically upward. So first go for this 2 seconds, then go for this 5 meters. Means along the T you will go for 2 seconds, then you will go for the 5 meters. So let me take this as 2, 4 and 6. So I have to first go along the time axis for 2 unit, then I have to go vertically. How much vertical distance we have to consider for the 5? 5 is in between this 4 and 6, so I have to stop here. So this point P will be our 5, not 5, but 2 and 5. So 2, comma 5. So these are the basic thing that you have to keep in mind that you have learned this thing in your 8th standard. Okay, student. So these things we have to apply. Even if I am not learned, then I had explained here, and I will explain everything by plotting each and every point one by one. So, students, for plotting this, what I have to do? I have to first take a vertical axis and another as the horizontal axis. I shall take the scale such that I can accommodate all the given point. Student, understand it carefully. The time is appearing to be varying from 1 to 12. So I shall divide this up to 12 unit. So let me put it. It is the 0. Let me take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Like we have done in our real number, the same way we have plotted this number. So this is what our time, and this time is in the unit second. So this way you have to write. Horizontal axis is representing which quantity? It is our time, and the unit of time is second. So this you have to write. Now, so time up to 12 we can put very conveniently over this time axis. Now similarly, you have to go for dividing this vertical axis. A student, if you have the graph, then please take your graph paper, that will be more convenient. You just take 1 centimeter as one unit and mark this 1, 2, 3, 4 along the horizontal axis and one along the vertical axis by taking two lines perpendicular to each other. That graph we have already learned in our mathematics, how to plot. But I'm just drawing it over this plain paper. Now take this position. Position is varying up to 36. It appeared me plotting 1, 2, 3, 4 continuously up to 36 is quite difficult here. So let me take the 3 or 4 unit itself. So let us take, I think even 18 is appear to be a bit difficult. Or let us take the 2 unit only. So whatever the 1 centimeter that we are taking, that corresponds to our 2. This next corresponds to our 4. Next corresponds to 6. So this way you have to write these numbers. I mean, you have to divide this vertical axis. 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32, 34. Okay, students, let me take it here at the 36. Okay, after what you have to plot this point. A student, observe carefully. When time is zero, position is zero. Means you want to put this point something when this time is zero, position is zero, like 0, 0. Means initially, when time is zero, means you are not moving from this position zero. So this zero, which is the intersection or crossing of both horizontal and vertical line, the time is zero as well as distance is zero. So this is our one of the point. Okay, so let us round it in the pencil. It is one thing. Next one is our, when time is 2, this position is 6. It means that, means I shall take time for 2. So move this 2 axis along this. You are able to reach here, but this is not the final position. You have to move 6 units upward. So you have to start moving upward, means drawing upward with the dotted line till you are able to reach up to 6. Okay, so from this 6, you first draw a horizontal line, then you draw the vertical line where these two lines are intersecting. That will give us the point for 2 and 6. So let us mark this point as this position as A, or let us mark this position as origin O, this position as A, this position as B, this position as C, this position as D, E, F. Just I'm marking for your understanding. So you may rewrite this point. This is O, so keep this O as it is. This is our A. Next one is, a student, again watch this. When the time is 4 unit, the displacement or the position is 12 unit. So you have to move 4 unit along the x-axis. Afterward, you have to start moving vertically upward for the 12 unit. So now not 2 but this 4. So this 4 is directly measured from 0 to 4. It is this one. From here you have to start moving upward, but how long you have to move? Till it is coming for the 12. So from 12 draw my counter line, and where it is intersecting you have to stop it there. Okay student? So this is our point B. Similarly, can our student plot for this 5 and 15?
Yes sir, between 16 and 14.
Very good. So from 5, so from 5 of this time axis you have to take this 5 and you have to start moving vertically, but you have to stop from between 14 and 16. So there will be something 15. So there you have to stop. Yes, it is this one. Now for the 6, it is also given as 18. So continue the same thing for the 6 and go for this 18.
D.
Yes. It is our 18. Please turn off. Okay, my pen have stopped working, so let me restart this. So students, it is this point somewhere here. Now coming for the next one, 10, then it is 13. So directly come to this 10, you start moving this, means this 10, you start moving upward. How long you have to move? You have to go for the 30. So from the 30 you have to take the another horizontal line. It is somewhere here. Okay students, then again for this 12, you have to start with this 12. Now you have to go for which one? 36. So you have to take this 36. It is coming somewhere here. After this you have to join all this. So joining all this, what we are getting? You will get this appear as a straight line. So this, so whatever this line which is what we have plotted, this line is our XT plot. So this tells us what is the position at what time. From this graph even we can calculate at 8 seconds what is the position. So question may be like this: at 8 seconds what is position of object? Students, so you have to start with this 8, mark it, this 8, understand this, whatever this 8 is here, from the time axis or on the time axis you allocate this point 8, then from this 8 you draw vertical line in upward direction, then observe where it is going to cut. You are observing it is going to cut somewhere here, and from here you have to draw the vertical line on the y axis. What you will observe that this y axis where this vertical line is going to cut, just I am plotting this vertical line, it is going to touch at this 24. So first you have to allocate this, from this you have to allocate this point, from this you have to allocate this point. So therefore this 24 will be the answer. Getting my point? So solution, or from the plot, from plot at 8 seconds position is what? 24 meter. A student, so therefore you have to understand very carefully that any point on this line always indicate two things. One is if I am plotting the vertically downward, so whatever this length, that will give us the time. And if I am plotting the vertically upward, means take the perpendicular on the y-axis, then upward distance will give us the distance position. So therefore, it is our xt plot. So this way, at what time, what is the position that can be predicted? That is one thing that we have to know. From xt graph, we can predict. Now for velocity. So what were the different section of this question? So tell whether the body is at rest or motion. Yes, student, whether the body is at rest or motion. See, motion. At different time, body is having different position. Therefore, it is in motion. Motion ka definition kya hai? Ki object ka different time at different position ho, then it is called as motion. So, right? Body in motion. Why? As it have different position at different time. This is very important to understand. So, a student, is it possible to plot the ST for a body at rest? Yes, that is also possible. A student, if I am taking the time here and distance here, say this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is our 2 meter. This is our 4 meter. This is our 6 meter. A student, if you are observing a body which is at a distance of 4 meter from you, means wherever you are sitting in your room, and just 4 meter ahead of you, you are observing a ball is laying. Okay? So this is your observation point 0, this is point A. Then whether you observe at 0 time, the position will be 4. Even after 1 minute or after 1 second, the position remains the same. Still, it will be at 4 meters. So whether t is equals to 1 or t is equals to 2, t is equals to 3, always x is equals to 4. X equals to 4. X equals to 4. Means this body at what? Rest. So for the body at rest, this position always remains the same. Means wherever you are sitting and object is just 4 meter ahead of you, then whatever the time you consider, means after 1 second you will see the body is still at 4 meter. After 2 second you will see the body is still at 4 meter. After 3 seconds, so any time you consider. Therefore at 0 second I am considering the body at 4 meter. Means at point A, even after 1 second, you will observe the position is still 4 meter. After 2 second, you will observe the body is still at 4 meter. At 3 second, you will observe the body is still at 4 meter. At 4 second, you will observe the body is still at 4 meter. At 5th second, you will observe the body is still at 4 meter. So how is this graph? This graph is a straight line which is horizontal or parallel to the axis. So this gap or this distance is x equals to 4 meter. So right here, so it is, write this as a note. So it is a plot. Which kind of plot? XT plot of a body at rest, not moving. So write this. The XT plot, XT means what? It is your distance time or position time. Graph or plot of a body at rest is a straight line parallel to time axis, is a horizontal line parallel to time axis or on time axis itself. It may be possible that on the time, if the body is at the origin, or on time axis itself. This is what we can understand. So the students, the XT graph is horizontal than body at rest, and if the XT graph is not horizontal, the body will be in motion. So it may be given that you have to determine whether the body is in rest or motion. That way the question is framed. So determine whether body in rest or motion. This thing. So the graph may be given. In the first one, you are given with this T and this X, and the graph is like this one. In the second case, you are given with this T and this X, and the graph is like this one. In the third, it may be given like this is our X, this is our T, the graph is like this one. In the fourth, student, please write these questions. So need not be this is straight line, but it is like this one, T, and this is X. The sixth one may be like this one. A student, in which case the body is in rest and in which case the body is in motion? So here it is.
Body is in rest.
Let me draw one more. So in first case we have observed that body is in rest. Even if it is given that this line only, means line is on this T axis itself. Okay, it is like this one. So students, let me write here whether, so you have to watch carefully. Whatever this X value or X1 value, whatever this T1, T2 you are taking, it is always same. Okay, so here X is always same. Therefore, which kind of motion, or whether the body is in motion or rest, it is rest. In rest. So this is how to identify. So what is rest and motion? In very first day I was speaking that the position is not changing. So this is the significance of position while we are plotting in a graph. Here, observe carefully. So initially the body is at this position, maybe your X1, but after some time this position has changed, X2. So X2 is different than X1, or X3 is different than X2. So if I'm considering this as X3, this way the position is changing. Therefore it is in what, rest or motion? So these are in motion. Also motion. Student, don't worry whether this graph is starting from T axis or X axis. Because in this case, the significance is that up to this time, say 2 seconds, the body was not moving. So up to this much position, the body might be in rest, but after 2 seconds, the body starts in motion. Okay? So in this reason, it is representing the rest, but for these reasons, I mean for this time or these reasons, it is in motion. Okay, student? Means initially for 2 seconds, the body was not moving, but later on, the body starts moving. From 2 seconds, the body have motion. So for initial 2 seconds, the body at rest, and later on, there is motion. It is continuously motion, though it is not uniform because the distance covered is not same. We will analyze more in our next class that what is uniform and non-uniform by watching this figure, how we can say, and this is right here, non-uniform motion. Again, this body is in motion.
Non-uniform.
For our non-uniform. And this motion, means in this second, it is yes. Our uniform.
Uniform motion.
Yes.
For the
so for the second part, it was uniform motion. For third part, wherever it was in rest, that is rest. So we cannot say rest is uniform or non-uniform. It is the motion where we can define whether it is uniform or non-uniform. So from 2 seconds onward, the body is in uniform motion. Now coming to the sixth one, whether the body is moving? No. The time, for any time, the body always have the same position, that is the origin. So body at rest.
Rest.
Yes. No change in position. So this way we can quickly identify. Okay, students? So in MCQs, it may be given, some of the graph will be given, whether the body is moving, uniform motion graph, non-uniform motion graph, body at rest, all these things. Here, keep in mind, I have plotted X versus T only. Next day, we will continue with speed versus time or velocity versus time. There we will see how is this uniform and non-uniform, all those things. Okay, student? So the other part of this question, I will do next day. Any doubt to any student, then please tell me. Otherwise,
no doubt, sir.
Please no doubt.
No, sir. No doubts.
No doubt, sir.